All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology again. And today we have a very special guest, and her name is Anuradha Sharda, as many of you know. So today she will be speaking on Anuradha Nakshatra from Scorpio. So welcome to Exotic Astrology. And she also has written two books, 27 Days, 27 Nakshatras. So, and the other book is on tarot, I guess. And she also has a YouTube channel. I'll pin the channel in the description below. So I request whoever is watching this video that please go and subscribe to the channel, and you'll find some amazing content there, especially so many things she has recently given on retrogression of planets, Saturn especially. So please go and subscribe to her channel also, so that you can also get updates on retrogression and other topics of nakshatras. So today Moon is transiting in Anuradha, and today she will also be talking on the same nakshatra. Okay, so welcome, and please let us know what do you want to speak.
Well, Babaji, today Moon in the morning was in Anuradha Nakshatra, and Anuradha Nakshatra being a very friendly nakshatra, it is that we chose to start on a very happy and a friendly note. Yeah. So I chose to start with Anuradha Nakshatra. So let's move on to Anuradha Nakshatra. Anuradha Nakshatra, as we know, is posited in the zodiac sign of Scorpio. Fully established in this sign, it occupies 3 degrees 20 minutes to 16 degrees 40 minutes of this zodiac zone. And so a lot of qualities that we will see in Scorpio is basically an impartment by this nakshatra into the Rasi of Scorpio. As the deity is Mitra, and we'll know and talk about Mitra in detail as we go along. The stars occupied by this nakshatra is the three stars in particular, very, very prominent ones. These stars are the Beta Scorpius, Delta Scorpius, and Pi Scorpius. And of the three, Beta Scorpius is the most, you know, brightest and the most easily recognizable in the zodiac. What is the Shakti of the nakshatra? Before means Anu means small, and Radha means the one, the devotee. A small flash of light is enough to connect the powers of the universe. So this nakshatra has the ability of connecting. This, because Anu means small and Radha means the lover, the worshipper, the consort, and the one who is the devotee of Krishna. So generally, if there is a planet in this nakshatra, you might find somebody who's a devotee of Lord Krishna. Apart from that, it is somebody, it was a sister of Anuradha, Anuradha, who loved Krishna as much. But because she came after Radha, so subsequently her love is also somewhat after Radha.
Okay.
Then also you will see that in today's life, you will find that this nakshatra has a reflection in love life of people. They could be a triangle.
Okay.
You also see that this these people will not get success right on. They would probably have to work for subsequent times before they reach where they want to reach. So the power of worship in this nakshatra becomes very high. Okay, and this now I move on to this Shakti. These people will have a lot of power of worship. This is Radhana Shakti, is the power or the Shakti associated with this nakshatra. Now, what happens with the Radhana Shakti? For you, me, most of us would think it's about sitting down, it's about praying and to your deity, being good to your deity, and then of getting something back in butter. Well, no, that is not the case. Whatever you do, if you do it with a dedication, certain amount of devotion, be it a peon or be it a CEO of a company. If you're putting in hard labor diligently, without fail, as is your duty, then you will see that systematically this moves into your system and your work becomes worship. Anything that you do with a lot of devotion involves the Shakti of this nakshatra. As we move on to another aspect of this nakshatra, it is the desire to be regarded as a friend in all the worlds. Now, what does that mean? You know, when in olden times it has been said that there were yagnas happening around. There were a lot of yagnas. So, you know, and the yagnas are actually energy houses. They're actually fires that is imparted on both sides.
Okay.
And in those days, only an Agnihotri, one which is well versed in the art of doing the yagna, would do those things. A Brahmin who was an Agnihotri. That means one who could give those abhilashans into the Havan Kund and as such would be able to recite certain mantras, so on and so forth. Now, what these yagnas would do was the devatas would take in what we had to offer in form of abhilashan to them and they would be energized manifolds. And when they energized, it became a duty for them to give back what we desired. And this is very categorically mentioned even in the Bhagavad Gita.
Yes.
So the Bhagavad Gita says that if you do not give back, so if you do not give the devatas, you do not make it a point to give them what you have, their share, then slowly and steadily your energy levels will start going down in life without you realizing. So you need to, that is why the very first thing that you do after you cook the food, in olden times they used to put it into the fire.
Oh.
As an oblation.
Okay.
So when there was oblations being done, Mitra, as one of the deities, he stood and he said that I want to be regarded as a friend in all the worlds.
Hmm.
So these people who have a planet anybody who has a planet in this nakshatra is a very affable person who connects to others very, very well and very fast.
Okay.
And as such, these people are honored and abundant. So these people have plentiful in life.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now let us take the case of Ramdas. Ramdas, he was born as Richard Alpert and he came from a very wealthy family, came from a very affluent family. He was born into a Jewish family. But he felt that there was something that was missing in him. Okay, once after he met Neem Karoli Baba and he had a lot of interaction with Indian gurus, Indian spiritual leaders, Indian saints and sages. And then there was an eventual change in him. And that made him change his name to Ramdas. Now he has his moon in this nakshatra of Anuradha. Moon is the second lord. Moon is also the house lord of moon, as such represents the left eye. And being the second lord becomes doubly connected to the eye.
Okay,
and he urged people, because this nakshatra gave him the impetus to do selfless service, he urged people to work with the homeless as he himself did. And he went ahead and he made hospitals for people, for treating people in the third world countries. But you see, it is aspected by Rahu, and it is also in the sixth house of conflicts. So here there is a certain amount of scandal attached, or a certain amount of legal issues attached, there's a certain amount of bad name attached because of being posited in the sixth house. And that was that he was fired as the Harvard professor because he was experimenting with LSD and other hallucination drugs.
Okay.
Sixth house is also about drugs. And when Rahu aspecting moon, the drug aspect or the intoxicant aspect comes into picture.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Interesting.
So we move on to our next panel of deity. Deity. Mitra is one of the deities of this nakshatra. Okay. There are multiple deities. You also have Saraswati, but today we will take up only Mitra. Mitra is an extension of Aditi, one of the 12 sons of Aditi. Who is Aditi? Aditi is the mother goddess. She is the goddess of, she's the mother of all the devatas.
Yes.
In fact, she's also the mother of, in all of incarnations of Lord Vishnu, he is born of Aditi.
Bhavan Dev.
Aditi is also the, she and Rishi Kashyap are said to be the parents and the of the devatas. Okay. Aditi has 12 sons who are also the sons. Okay. And these 12 sons are said to be the rulers of 12 different months, and they are an extension of one part of herself. Aditi is unbounded and she's the ruler of Punarvasu. So that stories we take up some other time. But Mitra is one of the Adityas, okay? And Mitra is a very colorful Aditya. So if you see, these people will have a lot of love for color, bright colors. They will not be liking drab colors like, you know, the dull gray or dull black or things like that. They have a very bright color. The orange, the yellows, the sunflower colors is something that these people associate with. He has a very positive and a sunny side to him. Okay. And he is a very, very, very affable person. Now, affable devata. Now, what does the word Mitra mean? Mitra comes from the root word of, again, as Mitra is the word, root word, and it means a friend. So what would your essential characteristics of a friend be? Somebody who supports you, who stands up to you for you, somebody who stands as a shield in time for you, who's non-judgmental, who doesn't believe in violence against you, who is very guileless, innocence in his interaction with you. Well, all these qualities you will find in this nakshatra.
Interesting.
So you have somebody who's a friend, who stands up for you, who stands up with you, who is beautiful in his approach to you. And as Lord Krishna says, a friend is somebody who doesn't need to be called. They come when there is a need. So Mitra deity, when if a true friend is somebody who understands and comes without being called. All these traits are present in those, in this characteristics, in this devata. And as such, these characteristics will further on be carried on by the person who has a planet in this nakshatra. So if you have a Venus sitting in this nakshatra, then there's some lady friend of yours who will always be coming to your aid when there's a need in life.
Oh, okay. Oh, interesting.
If there's a Saturn sitting in this plan, is house for you, you will always be guided by somebody wise, somebody old, who may be a very strict disciplinary, but nevertheless will help you through.
Yes.
Okay. And so on and so forth. This is now Mitra. He's also the Lord of contracts. Being the Lord of contracts, there has to be, when you're signing a contract with somebody, you just don't want to be the only one giving. You want to have something from the other side also. And how do we have something from the other side? How do we cover that part up? Well, it is about bringing two different people from two different areas, getting them into one platform so that all of us will be able to prosper. This is one very key attribute of Mitra. They have the ability to get people from diversified backgrounds, make them work as a group, and sustain that work for some period. So they make good lawyers also.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And so they might appear to be a very lovable, affluent, affable, very people who are exuberant, everything, very open. Well, they are all that, but they're very, 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 very tight about their inner circle also. They do not let everybody and anybody move into their inner circle. They appear to be very friendly, and they are friendly because that's their core nature.
Okay.
But they will not allow people to move into their zone, into their zone, until and unless they have tested that person very well. Now, if somebody has an afflicted planet sitting in this nakshatra, this person can be of two types. This person can either be a very big manipulator, depending on which house lord is sitting there,
okay,
or this person can be very, very strongly manipulated.
Okay. Both of them can happen.
Both of them, both sides. Okay. And we move on to Vishwanathan Anand in this example where I'm taking you. He has this ability to balance extreme types of people. Now, he has his Venus posited in Anuradha Nakshatra. Okay, Venus is the 5th and the 10th lord. So it's definitely a yoga karaka and placed in the 10th house, 11th house. Okay, 11th house of gains. A very, very strong position for the Venus, for Venus to be posited in. For people, Vishwanathan Anand is a grandmaster. Okay, he's defended his title many a times, and For the world, he's the first Indian grandmaster. A person who put chess in India at least on a different level. He's supposed to be a very unassuming personality. He doesn't show his airs, he doesn't throw his weight around, and he moves away from any politics that this game has to offer. And he doesn't move into the mind games, nothing at all. He just simply focuses on his game. And with that, we have, you know, the world's, during his time, we also, since I would watch his game, I know that Garry Kasparov and Vladimir Kremen, they were both rivals. They were both rivals, and yet they went ahead and helped him for the World Chess Championship together as such. So when I'm saying that, you know, he is a melting pot for people of different backgrounds, probably rivals, enemies coming together, it's not something that I'm exaggerating about. They do that. These people have the ability, the sincerity, as I said, because he was very, very focused on his game. And then the nature made sure that things just happened for him like that. Okay. And as we move ahead, again, we see that because this is the yoga karaka. Okay. Again, this game he plays with total focus and diligence. He has remained focused. There are so many landmarks in his life with this game. Again, because one of the deities of this nakshatra is Saraswati, learning becomes very important for this nakshatra, and also musical abilities.
Okay.
But this is something that I teach in my nakshatra course. This entire thing takes the form of 3 to 4 hours. So we are covering it probably in 40 minutes to 1 hour session. And we move on to the story of the deities. So the story of birth of Vashishtha. What is the story of birth of Vashishtha? Now, you have to know that there is Dvandh Devatas. What do you mean by Dvandh Devatas? In pairs, these devatas also exist in pairs. Like you could be very best pals with people. So you would be moving around everywhere you go, you're taking your friend along. Similarly, these devatas also move in pairs. There's certain pairs around. So you have Purva Falguni and Uttara Falguni as one pair. You have Purva Bhadra, Uttara Bhadra, Purva Shara, Uttara Shara, and certain pairs. That's the pair of nakshatras. Now let's see the pair of devatas. You also have Vishakha and Anuradha. There's another pair of nakshatras. But the pair of devatas that we have is Varun and Mitra. They are a pair of devatas who are always together or like to stay together. And one of them, okay, that is Varuna, is a very strict person. Varuna again is the ruler of the nakshatra of Satabhisha. And Mitra again is the ruler of Anuradha. These two are diametrically opposite, but probably opposites attract, very opposite. Very affable is our Mitra, whereas Varun is very strict. He doesn't give you any leeways. He just commands and he knows that he has to be obeyed. Mitra is affable. He likes to talk to people, get to know them, make grounds for them to work, makes things a lot more easy. Varun is like your very strict principal. Do my work, I have told you to do it. So now these two are always moving together. Once what happened was, these two came across Urvashi. And who was Urvashi? She was a celestial nymph. Very beautiful, known to be having the power of Cronus. So what happens is, when they approach her, one of them is accepted. Nevertheless, together they let their semen out, which falls in a pot nearby, giving birth to Agastya Rishi and to Vashishtha Rishi. These two rishis are the stellar personalities. They are Brahma rishis because they have the ability to know. The rishi is a person who knows the being, who knows the source and the origin. So what happens, as we see, is the Vashishtha, as we've seen, has been born, and Vashishtha is the originator. As we see, move down, we see that Vashishtha has a grandson named Parasara, whom he had to rear because he lost his son at a very early age to a demon, at the son's early age. So all the upbringing, all the training of his grandson moved on to sage Vashishtha. Okay, and sage Vashishtha, and you know who the grandson was? Grandson was Parasara. And who was Parasara? We all read, at least in Vedic astrology, we all read the book which is a Bible for us. It is Brihat Parasara Hora Sastra. So the writer of that book is BPHS, as we call it in, you know, in the short form, is sage Parasara. The bus does not stop there. The bus moves on further. Who became the father, the son of Parasara? Vedavyas. And who was Vedavyas? Vedavyas was the one who put the Vedas into their current form. Gave them, they were all mixed up. So it definitely speaks of a very stellar lineage. And Vashishtha Rishi was the Kulguru of Sri Ram, the Raghuvanshis.
Yes.
And it was because of Vashishtha Rishis that many Rishis like Vishwamitra and many other got enlightened. We will, if time permits, we will move into that story, or you can always have another session. So this, now what kind of inferences can you draw from